you have a Creality Ender 3 and you're having a problem with the extruder gear on the back of your Ender 3, I'm gonna show you how to take it apart, clean it up, and replace it if need be. Stay tuned, we're about to start. From Crazy Will's Tech Show. Today, I'm gonna be talking about fixing your Creality Ender 3 extruder. Pretty much the extruder gear on the back of the Ender 3. Every so often, I'll have a problem where maybe it dug in a little too much or the teeth are starting to wear away. Usually you can take the filament out, hit it with a wire brush, and you can go back to printing. But sometimes it gets a little too much where there's too much debris in there or the teeth wore away on it. Anyway, I'm gonna show you how to take apart that whole back end piece and get that disassembled, clean it up, put it back together, change out the gear if the teeth are bad on the gear, and then put it back together. So let's get over to the workbench and I'll show you how it's done.
Here we are at the extruder motor and we're gonna unscrew filament tube. Now you had a set of Allen keys that came with your printer. Find the right size and screw in the tension screw. Now that it's all the way in, now you have access to that hidden screw that was underneath the tension spring. Once you remove that screw, put it off to the side, and now we'll go for the other screw. I always like to hold the Allen key at the regular angle that it's meant to be in, and then flip it on its side and use it as a screwdriver afterwards. Just makes it easier to get out. Now we're going for a really long screw, quite a bit to unscrew this one. This screw is the one that holds the arm with the tension spring up against it, so it is extra long. Once we remove it, you can see all that lovely gunk. We'll remove that tension spring, and now we have access to one last screw. Once you loosen it, this is the last screw, so make sure you're cupping the motor underneath, that way it doesn't drop and break your bed. Once it's out, ugh, look how ugly and gross that is. There's a lot of crap in that motor. So we're gonna go ahead and take the wire out from the side of the motor. And yeah, this printer has about over 300 prints on it, and I've never done this. I've never cleaned this motor for it. So yeah, that's what it's gonna look like after 300 prints and hours of printing. So we're gonna take a wire brush and brush out all those little pieces of plastic that have been gathering up in there and get it all out of the motor and clean it up. That is the factory sprocket. I don't have to replace mine, but if you did, this is what it looks like. I bought these replacements online on Amazon, pretty inexpensive. You place it right on top here, and then there's a flat edge. You wanna put that one screw to the flat edge, screw it all the way in, and then the other one is just a tensioning screw, and you go ahead and put that in there. We're gonna finish cleaning up this extruder motor top. We're gonna brush it out right there and we're gonna get all that gunk out of there, all that shaved plastic, get it all out of there. And even the wheel, you can see how it built up on the wheel. That slows everything down and that's what makes you have that duke duke noise. So we're gonna make sure we clean all that up, get it nice. After that, it's time for reassembly. So we're gonna go ahead and put this right back on the top. Put that into place. We'll put the first screw right there. It was the first one we went for, which was underneath the spring. You're putting the engine back, make sure the leads are facing out just so you can put it back in there. And we're gonna go ahead and screw that down just enough so we can place it. And we'll go ahead and get the other screw on the other side here. And then we'll just tighten them up nice and tight. Now we're going to take that extra long screw, take the spring and put it on first, then get the arm with the wheel, and we're going to lay it down flat, and we're going to go ahead and put that screw in there, and that's just to hold it, and we're going to go ahead and loosen up that tension spring, so that way it's loose enough, back to where it basically was, that we can actually put this into place and screw it in. Now this one is a little bit of a challenge to try and get it in just right, but once you get it in, you'll have it operation right. Make sure you don't over tighten it like I did a little bit here. It was nice and loose to bring it, and then I over tightened it, and you could see that it's harder for it to move, so make sure you loosen it up where it's not struggling. All right, we're gonna go ahead and put in the last screw right there. Make that nice and tight. Everything should be nice and tight now and nice and clean. we'll go ahead and put the filament tube back in. Remember to keep that loose so you can change that filament. And just another test to see if that spring's working good, go ahead and plug back in your motor so that way it has power.
So yeah, that's how you take apart the extruder feeder mechanism on the back of your Ender 3. And you get all these parts on Amazon. They're pretty inexpensive. If you just type in Ender 3 parts, you get a list of stuff that you can go through and fix your Ender 3. And they're relatively inexpensive to get parts for this printer. And it's a very popular printer, and that's basically why I bought it and why I think it's easy to fix. That's it for me, guys. If this helped you anyway, please like and subscribe and ring that bell if you want to get notified when I make another video. And remember, you could do anything if you put your mind to it. Later, guys. Today I'm gonna show you guys how to clean. It's over. That's it, guys. I mean, there's other videos up there. Or if you wanna do me a huge favor, click the like button or subscribe button's even better.